how different was this book compared to the previous book that you wrote? And was it a difficult journey? Was it something that you had to sort of sit down and do a lot of research for?
My first book was a non-fiction book in which I had given 10 commandments which anybody follows, I believe, can achieve financial freedom. However, when I used to meet a lot of people and talk, like for example, if you ask a typical housewife, what are you doing about your money? Her answer will be, I don't know anything, my husband is doing it. Or you ask, see a young chap who has just come out of college, see an engineer, started earning very good money, then what are you planning about your future? About your marriage, about your children, etc. People say, just now I want to concentrate on my job, I want to earn money, I'll see all that later. Or if you ask a middle-aged professional in a very good job, earning very good money, then what are you planning about your retirement, about your children's marriage, etc. Typical answer will be, I have invested in so-and-so mutual fund or taken such and such insurance policy. I'm not saying we should not invest in the mutual fund. Obviously, if we don't have the time and the expertise, we should invest in a mutual fund or give money to some fund manager to manage. But at least we should have a simple minimum knowledge about finance, money, how money has been made, lost, and how to actually deal with our investments, etc. So, in that sense, then I thought that better to educate people in a more manner in which they will be able to actually, as I mentioned in my original speech, they will be able to relate with those things. Money is not an abstract thing, it is a part of our life. Everything in this physical world touches on money. So that is making a part of life and explain it in a more human form, in a more form of a story or fable, where everybody is able to relate to the situations and characters. And that is what gave me the idea of writing a finance fiction.
I have a question for Naram. I have always a bit of character that goes from experience or...
See, what I...
It's turned completely red. I think a couple of drinks at Chicken Center will be right.
What I think... What I believe is that the relationship between man and money is very different. Everybody has some different perspective. So if you see the characters in this book, there are different kinds. Like example, this is one, you mentioned this is one prostitute, there is one terrorist, there is one marathon runner, so there is some below. So there are...
How did you model that character from experience of reading a book or from Katrina Kaif? How did you model it?
Have you interacted with such a person in such a profession is what we want to know. And at what rate did you pay? And my dad wants to know, did you get a receipt?
I don't think we get receipts for such things.
Of course you get receipts. What kind of Parsi are you?
Any more questions in the audience? All right, we have something very exciting for all of you. We would give away special copies of the book. We're going to be doing something that we call as the financial quiz. It's not financial jargon, but it's just something that you need to sort of come forward and give us your views about. Three quick questions. Cyrus and Mr. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, if you could kindly pick winners if we have participants. If not, you all will answer the questions yourselves. All right. So please, this is for everybody in the audience. Please feel free to share your views. If you don't want to use the mic, that's fine too. It's a financial quiz, but yet it's not really technical in terms of the terms that we're using. So we'd just like to know your views in the form of this quiz that we've sort of drafted out. So I have three quick questions and three winners. Three of you get signed copies of the book by Mehrab. The first one, what is the single most important factor that comes between a man and his dreams? I know Mr. Jhunjhunwala and Cyrus would like to answer that right away. Come on, anybody in the audience, the single most important factor coming between man and his dreams. Yes, yes, please. If you just stand up, tell us your value about it, you convince yourself even more and you'll be able to. Yes, please.
Lack of knowledge point.
All right, so I think we have a fair round of answers. We have lack of knowledge. We have the fact that you keep reminding yourself that you can't do it in the first place. Fear. Cyrus, you have an answer.
I would like to give it to him if he doesn't ask any more questions.
Mr. Jhunjhunwala, what do you say?
I think
that's
good. Fear. Jhunjhunwala is our person. But he is towards the girl.
All right, my dear, we have a signed copy for you. And we are wishing Mehrab all the very best. Thank you, Mr. Jhunjhunwala. Thank you, Cyrus. And a special thank you to everybody in the audience for coming, for their questions. We request the lady who answered that last question. part of financial planning, some of the work we give you a signed copy. Also, for those who would like to get their copy signed, this book is very much available right here at Crossworld. Please do pick up your copy so you can get it golden signed. Thank you very much. So we meet again at the next launch at Crossworld. Thank you very much, everybody. Requesting the lady who took part in financial affairs to kindly come forward. We have a copy ready for you. I think we have a copy ready for you. Thank you.
No, of course not. Auntie, I pick up you every day, but in a very nice way.